Oopsies.
So I've got Boone, Eddie, Veronica. Yeah, most the rest of them I can grab, no problem. It'll just take me a little while to get them all. And send them all to my fucking apartment in the Lucky 38.
Evening.
Yeah, how you doing?
Welcome back.
Got a question about the crim... Yeah, I'm looking for any contracts common. No.
I'm afraid...
I'll take it. What do you need to do?
Deliver this invoice to Dr. Hildern. You can find him...
Okay. Okay. Depend on me. Hildern, he's at Cap McCarran. I know where he is because he was the asshole who sent me to Vault 22. Come on. Load on through. Come on. Load. There we go. Deliver the invoice. Then we'll quickly run to the brother to steal. Because I completely forgot we have, like, not even talked to them at all. Well, they're not even really the Brotherhood. They're more like the Sector of Steel. The Brotherhood's actually impressive. In this game, they're not that impressive. And you're still in here? You're still in here, good.
Hello. Yes? Something else you needed?
Invoice.
From Alice. I'll see that she's paid right away. Crimson Caravan runs a tight operation. Even out here in the waste, wouldn't do to keep them waiting.
Cool.
Was there anything else? Or were you just here about the invoice?
Just about the invoice.
There's a lot more troops here than we thought. No wonder we couldn't hold Helios 1.
Yeah, you guys kind of got your ass kicked because you guys were not prepared, and Elijah's a dick. Like, that's the main problem, is Elijah was a dick and just pretty much blew you guys all off. Where is it? No. Neil Shack. Hidden Valley. Oh, scorpions. I'm like, what the fuck? Oh, really? We were... Oh. Go figure. I didn't realize I was that close to the bunker. Is not. Wrong one, son of a bitch. You want to do it, Veronica?
You can't help but notice that the Brotherhood barely exists to these people out here. We're like an urban myth, no real presence on the outside. We just don't adapt like we should. Used to be that all you needed to get your way was a suit of power armor and a laser rifle.
Yeah.
Now, people are armed and organized. They're not afraid. but we still stick to our old approach because it's all we know.
If it's worked for this long, there must be something redeemable about their beliefs.
I think you're right. We're getting desperate. Hardly enough people to sustain ourselves as a chapter. We'll see the light, sooner or later.
You hope.
But I get the feeling if I don't take matters into my own hands, the change won't come in time to make a difference.
All right. I hope this isn't like a trap that I'm gonna like open the wrong door. That's it, just ammunition? That was it? All that for ammo? Eh. Could have been worse, I guess. Let's go... Go till daylight so that the sandstorm stops. So I can see where the fuck I'm going. There we go. Alright. There it was. Okay. I was going in the right direction. Slap me thrice and send me to me mum. You are going to smooth things out, Veronica, right? Because, like, I'd rather not get killed.
Hold on, I've got this.
By all means.
I'd like a large atomic shake and a double Brahmin burger. And easy on the agave sauce this time.
We gave you a password, Veronica. It's for your safety.
I know where you live, Ramos. Open up.
For Pete's sake, opening up. Welcome back, Veronica.
I think that was Ron Perlman. It sounds like him, but I don't think it is. Maybe. I don't know.
Listen up. I'm in charge of security around here, and I can't say I'm too happy about having an outsider waltzing around. But since you came in with Veronica, I'm inclined to cut you a little slack.
That's nice.
And we won't have any problems, okay?
Fair enough.
And the Elder's going to want to talk to you. He's on the second level. Just take a right once you get down there. My office is right here in case you need anything. Just ask for Ramos.
Gotcha. Nice Gauss rifle. Mine's cooler.
Looking sharp, Ramos.
Hey yourself, kiddo.
Elder McNamara. I admit I kind of want that flag. It's pretty neat. Just pretty neat. Level 2. To my understanding, this was a former enclave base the Brotherhood took over. Because these are enclave... This is enclave setup from Fallout 3.
When Paladin Ramos informed me that Veronica was approaching with an outsider in tow, at first I didn't know what to think.
How you doing?
After giving the matter some thought, however, I've decided that an outsider could be of use to me right now.
Why does everyone go automatically calling an outsider?
I will force you to help us. Should you refuse, you will be allowed to leave here, though you'd remain Veronica's responsibility.
Sounds about right.
What do you say, outsider? Are you willing to help us?
Duh.
Then allow me to explain our situation. This bunker is currently locked down, allowing no entry or exit, with you being one of the few exceptions.
Cool.
In exceptional cases, teams are sent out to investigate sites or retrieve materials deemed too important to ignore.
Fair enough.
Three such teams have gone missing recently, and the news of their disappearance has not yet been widely spread to avoid undue concern. To maintain the peace and adhere to the strictures of the lockdown, I need to send someone else to discover what happened to them.
But how did you lose your people?
I'm glad I can catch.
Excuse me.
Oh, and one other thing. The patrols each had a holotape detailing their missions that you can use to track them.
Okay.
The shielding of the bunker prevents us from actively tracking them, but their positions should show up on your map once you get to the surface. Should our worst fears become realized, please bring back all three of the holotapes from the patrols. Otherwise, bring our brothers home. I've given the order that you be given access to some of the equipment our scouts and patrols have scavenged over the years. You won't be allowed to purchase any prohibited equipment, but hopefully some of what's available will prove useful to you.
Thank you.
So, you're the outsider that's been given leave to wander around freely.
Yep, that's me.
Desperate times call for desperate measures, I guess. Name's Harden. I'm the head paladin of this chapter, and I think we might be able to help each other out.
Oh.
I don't know what the Elder talked to you about, but I can tell you this chapter is in trouble, and he's at the center of it. Are you
How
ready
so?
To listen to what I have to say?
Sure, go ahead.
As you may have already heard, this entire base is under a state of lockdown. No one goes out except small patrols at night.
Yep.
Most of the chapter has been sealed in here for years, and those few who were outside when the lockdown was initiated are forbidden from returning.
Veronica's allowed in and out.
As time has gone by, and many of our current paladins haven't seen combat outside of training simulations.
That sucks.
Because of the Elder's explicit order that no one be allowed in or out. The only way things will change is if a new Elder is installed.
But Veronica?
Veronica's a special case. She handles the procurement of supplies. If we didn't let her and those like her back in, we'd all starve.
Fair
if
enough.
If the Elder could manage it, he'd shut them out as well. And all
Ooh.
In the name of security. Which is why we need to replace him.
I see.
Of course I have. Many times, in fact. The Elder has an open-door policy and will listen to advice on any subject save this one.
Oh.
He refuses to see that our isolation is slowly weakening us. Aside from being our duty, going out on missions is what kept us strong. And because he fails to see that, he must be replaced.
Okay. And I suppose you nominate yourself?
I would. I'm the senior-most paladin in the chapter, and have more combat experience than any two others here put together. I'd gladly support another candidate, but no one has the courage to step forward and make the attempt, so it falls to me.
Okay.
I would put this chapter back on the right path, if I could just assume leadership.
How do you propose?
I don't know. I've gone through our records dozens of times looking for a precedent regarding the dismissal of an Elder and come up with nothing. The people who are most likely to know how it could be done are also some of McNamara's strongest supporters, so they refuse to help me, which is why we're having this conversation. An outsider such as yourself would arouse less suspicion asking questions about such matters. The fact that the Elder has some tasks for you means his faithful won't suspect you, and you have a line open to the man himself. In short, you're in a perfect position to help me. Will you at least think about it?
Yeah, I'll think about it.
That'll have to do. I'd recommend going to see Ramos first. As head of security, he's more familiar with our protocols than anyone else here. You could also try to find something relevant in our data store.
Yeah.
Last I heard, Scribe Ibsen is having a bit of a problem accessing it.
Oh.
And if McNamara should give you any tasks, I'd ask that you kept me abreast of them.
Okay.
Report anything you find to me. And we'll move from there.
Gotcha. So where's that damn store? Because I want to buy some stuff. Nope. That's the med bay. Paladins. There you are.
The word came down from the Elder that I'm to offer you some of our lesser wares, as if I didn't have other matters on my mind.
What you got? Show me what you got.
Our patrols are always bringing more stuff in. Take a look.
Take some of those, take some of these, some of these. 12 gauges are always a good addition. 40 millimeters. Ballistic fist? What? A ballistic fist. Boom. That just sounds cool. Greased lightning. Chicks with queen bumper, grease lightning, grenade machine gun. I can't believe that's actually a thing in this game. I really can't believe it. Come on. Give me this, thank you.
Pleasure doing business with you. Bye.
You don't got much, so.
The bunker takes a little getting used to, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's a fucking enclave bunker. You took it from them. I'm gonna guess you beat the shit out of them and took their stuff. I played Fallout 3. I know this is an enclave bunker. I'm not stupid. What level am I at now? Wait, level 39. Okay.